how to get by. You need to do what society tells you to do. F that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Worried about money. All the people, everybody has been worried about money and this and that. So you gotta work, or you gotta be skimpy with your money and all this.
We don't believe in that, dude.
What are you worried about? You know?
We don't believe in that. Not at all. You see how we live. We live to help people. This is what I love to do. This is what this man loves to do. We're helping people. This is what we live for. We don't live to make $7 an hour the rest of our lives doing what we hate.
He's smoking now.
I know he is. You know, I saw the blunt in your hand a few minutes ago. I didn't want to say it at first.
It reminded me of Bob Marley a little bit when it's a smoky picture, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, I saw the blunt like 5 minutes ago. Like, I saw you get lighting it up, and I was like, I wonder if I should speak at this or not. But it's the truth, you know? Like, you like to smoke a blunt. What's wrong with that? Nothing.
He's not confident.
He's just sitting there, like, puffing away. I can see him, this light of blue-colored smoke going around him. It reminds me of Henry, Andrew's friend, like, pulling up the lazy boy. Like, he comes to talk, the lazy boy appears, and he fires up a blunt. And I'm like, wow, he's coming from the other side. But
very cool.
But look, D, man, you know, I want to say, do you have anything special you want to throw out and say, brother?
He just wants to holler at his boys, tell his family that he loves them, and peace. That's what
peace.
Yeah,
because look, you know, in due time, y'all are going to catch up, you know what I'm saying? You know, when it comes time for y'all to cross, shit, this man is going to be here. You know, be waiting for his boys and his family.
That's right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
this man is happy, you know?
And he's, like, kicked up against a wall with his, like this, like, I can't show you, but you know,
he's got this chilling, big, fat blunt in his hand.
Just chilling, smoking. Nonchalant, very nonchalant.
I like that, D, you know? Chilling, I respect that, my brother. But, I was going to touch on one more thing for the benefit of his family. What was it? I wanted to touch back on that party thing one more time. This is important. Like, these people are grieving for him. Time to move on.
Yeah.
Time to let go of that grief. Time to have a blast. Throw a massive, big-ass party for him. Get a bunch of women over. You know, I'm talking more as friends here. You know, get some women over and get a bunch of girls or something. You know, get a bunch of liquor or something. Just smoke some weed. You know, and just like, you know, like, hey, Drick, man, you know, I know you're here, and he will be there. You know, he'll be dropping in, partying with you.
Yeah.
You know, that would be good for him. You don't know how good that would be for your friend, you know.
Right.
If you all laughed and smiled and got fucked up and danced around and tripped off each other in a happy way. You feel that, dude? I know that you'd be happy to be at an event like that,
yeah.
Over preferably somebody weeping and crying. I just wanted to touch on that for the benefit of your people before we close this particular out. But look, man, you know, like I told you before, anytime, man, if you can do anything for you, man, you know, just when it comes to... You come and chill, my brother. You know, I like you, man. You cool ass dude, man.
Okay.
I respect you. You know, just any time, man. Same with Jeremy. Jeremy and I just chill with y'all. Y'all are just as real as physical people to us, you know? I mean, y'all are there, except we're here, you know? But just same thing.
That's right.
But listen, though, if you want to talk to us at all, we don't charge anybody anything. We never have. Me and Jeremy do this because we care about people, you know,
we want
to do this. This is our work, you know. We don't do just these videos, but we do grief retreats for people, like to help get out their emotional pain. We talk to people and all over the world. People call us from Europe sometimes for help. We've had people call all over the states. We do everything, you know, whatever it takes to teach spiritual truth, we do it. You know, we talk to young, we talk to old, we talk to black, we talk to white. Anyone, you know, that's what we're about. But my number is 804-641-9082, and my name's Matt.
And my name's Jeremy. My number is area code 804-325-0995.
And you see some of the other email addresses on this YouTube page and whatnot, so no, email us too, or whatever you want to do, Facebook, call, but don't be sad, I'll get you in touch, we're here to help. And if y'all want to talk to him again, he'd probably pop on through, talk to you, I know he would. This man is cool. I like you.
Yeah.
He's way back.
Yeah.
He knows some of my people, too. He knows Tony and people, Dot, all of them, from around the way. So it's all like we got a little connection already anyway, from physical to this world. But
that's right.
But I guess we'll leave it at there. But I hope this helps. Like, this is lighten up on the grief,
yeah.
It's going to help him. It will help y'all, Drick, out for real. It will. It'll help you out, too. Like, when you start laughing and knowing he's having fun, oh, man, your heart will be so joyful, Me and Jeremy don't ever get upset when people die, no matter who they were.
Forgive and forget,
Forgive and forget, too. Like, he's all right. I mean, despite the way he went out, somebody murdered him.
Yeah.
Still, it's hard to hear this, but forgive.
Forgive.
It's important.
It is important.
It's going to just tear you up if you have that anger inside of you. What's just going to hurt you more and more and more. It's destroying yourself. So, but just something to keep in mind. But we're here for you to help. If you just need to talk or anything, we're here to help. All right. Well, bless you all. Peace be with you.